fixer-upper, how to get your house ready to sell. That's our topic today. Let's get started. Hi, I'm Kim Ward. Welcome back to my channel. I'm an expert at helping executors, administrators, and trustees with homes that are in probate or a trust. And when you become responsible for a real estate that a loved one leaves behind, my team and I are here to help. We help sell fixer-uppers. Are you wondering how to get the house ready to sell? I've put together 5 tips to help sell a fixer-upper fast. Here in San Diego, when a house is properly priced for its condition, they tend to sell fast, including fixer-uppers. So fixer-uppers are a unique opportunity for home buyers. Much of the time, a home buyer is able to purchase them for below market value based on their condition. And the buyer has the benefit of being able to renovate the home to their liking. So if you need to sell a fixer-upper and you want it to sell quickly, for the most money and the best terms, these are my tips. The bottom line is we want to get the most people in the front door because more people looking at the property means the potential of multiple offers. My favorite thing. I love to negotiate when there are multiple offers for my sellers. So tip number one is to set the price right. Here in San Diego, pricing at market or even a little bit below will entice buyers and get as many people in the front door as possible, and we get multiple offers. Now, you want to take into consideration the type of offers they are. Unfortunately, cash is king, so when a cash buyer comes in, most of the time a buyer with a loan will not be able to purchase the property, depending on what the pricing is. Tell you a quick story. My daughter, Ashley, and her husband, Ray, just purchased a fixer-upper in Santee. Now, we're in the process of renovating that home to their liking. The house was in original condition, built in 1965, had a very tiny kitchen, and it just didn't suit their needs. But I knew that we could turn that home into something that they would love, and they would have the benefit of, one, learning to work really hard, and two, the equity bump they would get from their sweat equity. Tip number two, be realistic about the condition. Traditional buyers and even investors are going to do home inspections. Now, the investors may just bring in their contractor and be more okay with the condition of the property. A traditional buyer, especially a first-time buyer, may have more reservations about even small things that are wrong with the property. So we need to be ready to do some negotiations once the buyer does their inspection, and they may discover things that need to be repaired for health and safety reasons. That's why the cash is typically king, because they'll take on just about anything where traditional home buyers will be more cautious and even scared of even small things that are wrong with the property. So it's really important that you, with your agent, talk about disclosing anything that you are aware of that may be defective in the property. If you're aware that during the time that your loved one was living there that the roof had been leaking and maybe they just patched it instead of replacing the roof, it's important that you disclose it. Tip number three is to highlight the positives. Your fixer-upper may be in need of significant repairs, but that doesn't mean that it doesn't have any valuable features. Depending on when the house was built, it may have stunning hardwood floors underneath the carpet. That's why I always pull back some of the carpet to see if there are hardwood floors under there. It's very inexpensive to have old carpet removed and expose those floors. That's a value add for your home buyer. Maybe here in San Diego, the zoning of the property allows for a helper unit. Buyers really appreciate the flexibility of being able to put another home on the property. Sometimes the garage may be plumbed with a shower and a toilet. That's a value add. It's important to identify these features and to properly market them and highlight them, making them worthy of an investment by a home buyer or your cash investor. Number four is to market to traditional buyers and to cash investors. When I am helping with a fixer-upper, most of the time, unless the house is in extreme disrepair, I market to both traditional buyers and investors. We're always looking to get a traditional buyer because they will pay more. But with that, there are some hurdles, including that the buyers will be more picky, like I mentioned earlier. There will need to be an appraisal, and sometimes the appraiser may call out things that must be repaired as a condition of the loan. But there are many buyers out there, like my daughter and her husband, who are willing to put in that sweat equity. And as long as the house is in move-in condition, and I know that an appraiser will appraise it at the agreed upon purchase price, I much prefer to sell a property to a traditional buyer. So another way that I market is because I am an expert here in San Diego with homes in probate or a trust, much of the time they have deferred maintenance. So I make sure I always market those properties to the investors that have contacted me and asked to be notified when I have a fixer-upper. My team and I will send an email to over 80 investors letting them know that this property is on the market, and I also hold a special open house just for investors. That way they're all there at the same time mulling around, and it helps to get the price up for my seller. So tip number 5 is, yes, to get an experienced agent, someone who can really help you to press the easy button and walk you through all the pros and the cons of selling to an investor or selling to a traditional buyer. And you also want someone who knows how to properly market to both traditional and investors, and to be able to thoroughly negotiate when the time comes and you have multiple offers. Bottom line is, we want to get the best price and the best terms quickly for the estate. Thank you for watching. If you found this of value, please hit the thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe, hit the bell button to be notified of my weekly videos. And if you have questions or comments, just post them below. I'll be sure to answer your questions. Thank you for watching, and have a great week.